Welcome in this new episode of 1 Year with Film Only. Today I show you my way of developing black and white film. There are as many techniques to develop black and white film than there are photographers. The combination of film, developer, agitation or temperature will all affect the final result. The technique I'm going to share with you today is the one that worked for me and pleased my taste. But feel free to adjust it and don't follow this word for word. There are many ways that I say to develop film, so feel free to experiment. The type of developer you use will be the most important part of the whole process. This is what will determine the look of your image. I'll put a link to the article in the description so you can have a look in more detail about how it works and how the agitation will impact the negative. The second step is the stop bar. This is simply made to deactivate the developing agent and stop the process. I use the Ilfo Stop, but you can use also tap water. The only difference with tap water is that you have to let it work for a longer time to deactivate completely the developer. The third and last step is the fixer. This is what makes the image permanent on the film and that you can expose it to light. Just after this step, you can wash the film and it's ready to use. I just had a fourth step that is optional to the process, but I highly recommend it. Just after you rinse your film, you can drop it in the wetting agent for a minute or so and then hang it to dry. This chemical will allow the film to dry evenly and without any watermarks. Now that we know how the magic happens, let's get started. For today, we are going to develop this roll of foam pen that was shot by Dan, who is hiding behind the camera. Say hi, Dan. And we're gonna use the Rodinal. It's a famous developer that is often recommended for anyone who gets into black and white developing. If you want more information about it, check again the link in the description. For today, I'm gonna do a dilution of 1 plus 100. This means that we need one dose of developer and 100 times the same dose of water. So we need in total 300 milliliters of solution. So I'm gonna put 3 milliliters of developer for 300 milliliters of water. Before I forget, the water should be at 20 degrees. That's important, otherwise you will have to adjust the developing time. Okay, then agitate the developer for a minute or so, and it's good to go. I finally managed to put the film inside the tank. So just check the temperature of the developer, which is at 20 degrees, so it's perfect. I've set the timer for 10 minutes. So what's gonna happen is, I'm gonna put the developer inside now. I'm gonna agitate for a full minute, then let it rest. And at the beginning of every minute, I will do 4 inversions. Like this. 3 and 4. Then, don't forget to tap the tank a couple of times. This is to remove the air bubbles from the surface of the film. So let's go. While the developer is working, let me explain you a bit about agitation. The agitation is basically made to refresh the developer and to make sure the film is always in contact with fresh developer. The amount of agitation you're gonna do will impact the contrast and the grain of the film. If you don't do any agitation, you will have a low contrast and a fine grain film. If you prefer a higher contrast image, you will have to do more agitation, but it will also make the grain slightly bigger. It's time to empty the tank. The developer is a one shot, so you don't reuse this. You have to do a fresh developer for every film that you develop. Now we have to stop the development process. So I have here a bit of stop solution that I've prepared. This one you can reuse it, so save it in a bottle. Make sure that it's airtight. And then just put it inside for 10 seconds or something like that. Again, if you use fresh water, let it inside for about a minute and shake it a bit. The point of the stop bath is also to neutralize the developing agent and that it doesn't contaminate the fixer. another fixer. I usually fix my film for 3 minutes. I'm going to use the same sequence than before, so 1 minute agitation at the beginning and then 4 inversion at every minute. Okay, now we're gonna rinse the film in water, so come with me. For those of you who haven't watched my video where I develop film with Guinness, my technique to rinse film is very simple. They're gonna be 3 baths. So with the first bath, we're gonna do 5 inversions, then put fresh water inside, 10 inversions, and again with third time fresh water, 20 inversions. And after that, the film is clean. Okay, so the film is now clean. We're gonna just finish quickly with the wetting agent for 1 minute and we're done. You don't need to do any agitation or inversion. Just let it inside for 1 minute or so and that's enough. Let's see if we have images now. Today, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode and that it could give you some confidence to develop black and white film yourself. Again, there is no right or wrong way to do this. This is just my way and what I like, but feel free to experiment to adjust the developing time or temperature until you find the style you're happy with. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you enjoyed this video and want to follow the channel, and give me a thumbs up, it will encourage me to continue. See you guys.